Welcome to our second presentation for DipTrace. Here we're going to take our schematic, which we've already built, and convert it to a PC board. After we've run our verification, make sure that our schematic's correct, I go through and I check a few things to make sure that it'll put together a nice board. And we're going to be using PC board layout from our DipTrace launcher, but it should automatically open up PC board layout when I go to create it. So let's get this. So I go through and I right click on the components, look at properties. Okay, and I look at the attached pattern. Here I make sure that it looks okay, and I go ahead and I check the pads. Okay, these are pads. And I make sure that the drill hole size and it's thick enough on the round. We're not going to change these on this one, but eventually we'll need to do that to make sure that we don't have too many drill sizes when we build the board. Let's just check our transistor. Properties, okay, attached pattern. EBC, that's good. That's a TO92. And let's check our pads. A little on the small size, but we're just going to allow it to continue. So let's go to File, and we're going to convert to PC board, Control B. And it should open up our DipTrace and go right to the PC board layout software. And we're going to use schematic rules. And we have some components scattered. And they're kind of in the right mode here. So let's what we can do is, and I don't use this very much, but sometimes it helps square these things up. Let's just go to placement and do arrange components. Okay. And let's go ahead and take a window view, zoom window. And I'm going to roughly lay these out just like we did on the schematic. Make sure that we have proximity. The blue lines are what we call rat lines. Okay, they are the connections, and we could go from there and we could figure out where everything's supposed to go. So let's go ahead and move our battery way over here. And we have, let's lay out a resistor like they are in the schematic. So we got R4, R2, and R3 is over here. Good. So we kind of put them in order. Let's take a look at this guy. He looks tight in knots, so let's rotate him. Let's put our capacitors in. Let's see, this guy looks kind of tied to that one. And that one looks kind of tied to that one. Let's just see how that works out for us. And yeah, that one looks skewed. So let's flip him around. Okay, let's turn our LEDs. Let's put our LEDs flat down. It looks okay. Let's go ahead and move that guy over a smidge, and let's go ahead and build an auto route. Let's do an auto route. So we're going to go to route, run auto router. So I'm going to start here just like that, and that's a pretty reasonable schematic right off the bat. So let's go ahead. That's at the top. Let's take a look at the bottom. Okay. Yeah, that's getting close. That's a little more complicated than we want. So let's take a look what we need to do here. So let's go back and let's go back to the top and let's do an unroute all. It looks like my little capacitors here are goofy, so let's go ahead and rotate him. How about that? Oh, that looks a little better. You know, for grins, let's rotate all the resistors, see what happens. And this is just trial and error. Looks perfect. Now let's run the auto router again. Top looks good. How about the bottom? Oh, that's better. Yeah, good. So now what I usually do is I go ahead and find the net layer. So we're going to go ahead and I make the ground and the power larger. So I go to the net width and let's just make it 0.9. And that's just trial and error. Cool. And let's take our positive side. We're going to have to go to the bottom to get him. And we're going to make our net width custom 0.9. Good. And let's turn them over, and it looks like we've got a good PC board layout. And this one looks like a reasonable site. It chose a thing for us. What we are going to need to do is find the size, because they're going to need to know that when they build the PC board. So let's use a little measuring tool here. Here's our vertical measuring, and let's just leave it like that, and let's save it, save as, and we're going to use the same name that we use on there. So let's go to DipTrace projects. Good. Let me see if I can. Okay, I think it's flip-flop one. Close enough. Okay, and it's escape and get out of there. And let's go ahead and do a verification, make sure it's okay. I'm going to check the design rooms. No errors found. Good job. So we're finished building a PC board. This one's pretty simple and actually looks pretty nice just using the auto router.